Now, this torment was not just a mental thing, it was a physical thing. He actually felt sick. And I think we should be suspicious if our body starts to act funky. We need to ask ourselves, why? What's coming around that bend? And what should I do about it? Okay, I'm going to pray. I suspect, you know, maybe sickness is coming. Maybe an illness is coming. Maybe I don't need the flu for 2 weeks. There's all kinds of stuff that's going to be released, right? So we should pray the scripture that says things like, for the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus makes me free from the law of sin and death. And if sickness or disease tries to touch me, it has to die.
Yes.
Because usually,
yes,
we may not exactly know, but it could be money. You know, and let's say, for example, you know, you're, God forbid, you were going to take a financial hit, an unexpected bill, God forbid. And we had a little sense of it, and we were feeling horrible about it. Maybe we should pray in that direction and say things the scripture would say, like, he takes away the wealth of the wicked and puts it into the hands of the righteous. I'm not going to lose money. Money's going to come to me.
Yes.
Rather than just let it go and just think, well, I don't know why. I'm under the weather today. Because Jesus, what if Jesus would have said, you know, I'm just under the weather today, guys. I just don't really feel like going around healing the sick today or casting out any demons because, man, I feel horrible. I feel like I'm even going to die, you know? Why don't you guys just go ahead of me, you know? He didn't say that.
I felt
he went
like
and
that.
He prayed, and he... See, he had a prophecy, and that prophecy said that he was going to be the Lamb that takes away the sins of the world. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
The Lamb that takes away the sins of the world is what John said after he was baptized.
Yes.
Baptize me, John. John said, no, you have to baptize me. He said, baptize me that all scripture must be fulfilled. So he knew, because when Jesus was 12 years old, he used to go to the temple and have conversations with the high priest, and they were like, wow, this guy knows more scripture than we do. You know, and bring him back. I get my sermon today. What was he saying earlier about Isaiah? Yeah, I like the strike thing. You know, little knowing he was talking about himself.
Come on now.
Trying to explain to him, man. I am he. You know, right? I'm the one. I'm, you know, he. You know, so Jesus knew, I'm going to have a crucifixion. I'm going to suffer at the hand of sinners. I'm going to be have my beard plucked. I'm going to be spit in the face. They're going to cover my head and hit me over the head and tell me to prophesy and mock me, but I don't know when. But by the Spirit, he did know when, because he said, you know what? It's coming, guys. It's just a matter of time. Because a little later is when Peter tells him, far be it from you, Master. You know, you're not going to get crucified. And he tells him, get behind me, Satan.
Come on.
You're not mindful of the things of God. You're mindful of the things of men.
Amen.
You know, so I think we really, really need to pay attention to our state. Unless Jesus, you know, if he was fully God, then he wouldn't have the troubles that we have. But since he was God and man and God, then he's laying the pattern for us that we too are going to feel and sense things before it comes. Though this will not always tell us. Well, like I was trying to say a moment ago, I have prayed for people and I knew that they got physically healed, but here they weren't healed. So what I would do to them is I grab by the hand and pull them real quick before they can think about it. And before they know it, they're already walking. So this way their mind cannot argue. I say, look, you're walking. So you couldn't walk, but now I've made you walk. Are you going to cripple yourself again? And they can't recripple themselves because I did it too quickly. Prayed for them, I seated it, and I'm like, get up, get up. And I walk them around. And then they had a cane, you know, whatever, you walk them around, and they're like, you know, and all that stuff, you know, and then I'm like, tell them, don't just take it back. You're healed. You couldn't do that earlier? No. But their mind was like, their mind was doing this number, you know. They have to catch up, you know what I mean? So, if it works with like that, well, it must work in other ways. You know, before something comes, our body may begin to register something through torment, through depression, through stress, through fear. Hey, later on today, you're going to get some information that's going to knock your socks off, and you're not going to like it. You better start praying. You're just like, man, I got a horrible headache. I'm angry. I'm frustrated. I hate everybody. I don't even know why. Oh, Lord. Am I going to get to where I'm bitter later? Oh, my Lord. Is someone going to do me wrong? Lord, take me through that situation. I pray for rebuke right now. Please take me through that situation. I don't know. And why I'm feeling this way, but I believe my spirit knows. It's an eternal thing. My spirit knows. Amen?
Amen.